We're going down the repentance road here. We're going to look, what is the baptism of repentance as it was introduced in the New Testament? Look at verse number 2. As it is written in the prophets, "Behold, I send my messenger before thy face, which shall prepare thy way before thee." So why was John the Baptist sent? To prepare the people. Look at the next verse. "The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his paths straight." John is saying, get ready for the Savior. Get ready for the Messiah. He's coming. Verse 4, "John did baptize in the wilderness and preach the baptism of repentance for the remission of sins." Now here's where some people get mixed up. Well, wait a minute, it says for remission of sin. Does that mean you're getting remission of sin? Does that mean you're obtaining remission of sins if you get baptized? Listen, baptism does not save. Baptism does not save. Repenting of your sins does not save your soul. When it says for, that means because of. Like the wanted for murder poster. Everybody, wanted for murder. Does that mean wanted? We need somebody to murder? No. It means you're wanted because you did murder. So here when he says, get baptized because you have been forgiven of your sins. John the Baptist preached the gospel. John the Baptist was a prophet of God. He said, guess what? Destruction is coming. Guess what? Hell is real. Remember what he said to the Pharisees in Matthew chapter 3? Warning them of hell, saying you will be cast in hell. John the Baptist was a Baptist preacher preaching revival, saying believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. His whole message was get saved, then get baptized as a picture that you have changed, that you are no longer spiritually dead, you are alive, and prepare the way for the Lord. He's coming. He's coming. He's got plans. He needs you. Look, John the Baptist was Old Testament. John the Baptist did not preach the name of Jesus. He never met Jesus. He preached salvation by faith alone in God, that God would send the Lamb. Right? What did he say when he saw Jesus? Behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sins of the world. That Lamb was slain from the foundation of the world. When Jesus created the earth, he knew he would die for us. He knew who would believe that. That's been the message all along. He knew who would repent, turn in their mind, and change their mind about working their way to heaven. Listen, if you're trusting in repenting of your sins to get saved, you need to repent of that repentance and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. If in your mind you say, I don't even know if there is a God or if there is a heaven and a hell, you need to repent of that and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Yeah. If you believe, well, I'm a good person, I do good works, I put my money in the offering plate and I take care of my family and I do, you need to repent of your works and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ alone. Amen. Repentance means to change. So look here, he's saying turn to forgiveness, right? Turn to forgiveness and then get baptized. This is a Baptist revival. And we need another one of those. Yeah. Acts chapter 8, it says, here's water, what doth hinder me from being baptized? It said, if thou believest with all thine heart. Somebody comes up and says, hey, I think I'm ready, I want to get baptized. We had a guy here a year ago. And I asked him, I said, are you sure you're going to heaven? He said, man, I don't know, I'm pretty sure, I think so, yeah. I just got to get baptized so I know. I said, whoa, wait a minute, that's not right, that's wrong. I compelled him out of the scriptures, I showed him. He was so worried about his past and doing drugs that he just needed this moment, this experience, so he can point back and say, oh yeah, I prayed the prayer, I dunked in the water. Guess what? He wasn't trusting in Jesus Christ. He was trusting in an emotional experience. He had to repent of believing that baptism saves. Before I would baptize him, I needed to make sure he was saved. Because there are people that will get baptized that are not saved. There are people that repent of their sins, they're not saved either. But look, Christian, you're saved. Repent of your sins. Act like a Christian. Obey God. You better believe he will correct you. That's why he's given us the word of God. He showed us what he did to Israel. He destroyed their household. Do you want your household destroyed? No? Then obey God. Hearken to his commandment. Read the word of God. Obey. Do what he says. This life is not forever. Your soul will last forever. Look what he says here in the next verse, verse 5. And there went out unto him all the land of Judea and they of Jerusalem and were baptized of him in the river of Jordan, confessing their sins. What do you do after you get saved? You get baptized. What do you do after you get baptized? You ought to confess your sins to the Lord every day. You ought to confess your sins. Lord, I did it again. Lord, I messed up. I didn't mean to, but I did it. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves. Oh, Jesse Morrell, I'm perfect. No, if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. That's in 1 John chapter 1. That's at the end of the Bible. That's not written how to be saved. That's written how to live now that you are saved. As a Christian, you ought to repent of your sins every single day, moment by moment. Keep a short account with God. Don't save them up until the weekend. Well, I better wait until Sunday morning before I ask for forgiveness for all. No, don't wait until, well, all I know is I pray that prayer every night. Well, what if you don't wake up? What if you don't make it tonight? I pray in the morning. Look, pray all the time. Pray without ceasing. Ask God as a Christian, Lord, forgive me. I did it again. Be patient with me. Be long-suffering. Give me the power through your Holy Spirit to overcome this sin. That's why we confess our sins on a regular basis, not to man, to God. He's the one that can do something about it. And if you refuse to confess it, if you say, I have no sin, I have not sinned, then God is righteous and really coming down on you and correcting you hard. Oh, yeah. But yet, if your heart is that, Lord, you know I want to get it right and I keep struggling with this thing, then God's like, I'm going to take it easy because I see that you've turned in your heart. Now you're just trying to get the body to catch up. Understand the difference. Look at verse 15 in this chapter. This is very important. Mark 1:15, and saying, the time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel. If you're not saved, you need to turn from whatever you're trusting in or not believing in, and you need to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. You need to trust in Him alone for salvation. When it says, repent and believe, what is repentance? Turn and believe. Turn and trust. Go to Luke chapter 1. He's saying, change your mind about having faith in God. Oh, you've heard of Jesus, but if you don't believe He's God, if you don't believe He's your Savior, you need to repent of that. You need to turn around and put your trust in Him to be saved.